Aaron, now contrary to what we see on TV, scientists actually can't get enough significant DNA from hair strands that are left on shirts or sweaters without the root. Scientists tell me the shaft of the hair doesn't have enough DNA for current technologies to process that. So this lab is able to process those strands with small DNA sizes.
It's not so crazy anymore to get profiles off hair. Now we've kind of created solutions to access this material that has been underused for decades.
That material is from the shaft of the hair. Researchers say oftentimes law enforcement agencies will test hair by comparison or let it sit in evidence for years and degrade, creating backlogs.
We'll take a single hair and we'll do a single extraction from a single hair after washing it.
It starts here at the UC Santa Cruz Biomed Lab, led by Professor Dr. Ed Green and his team of three. The process can take up to a month or longer. They're busy testing hundreds of hair samples sent from law enforcement agencies across the country. The team first suits up in a sterile room to wash the hair, one strand at a time, and extract DNA.
Because even breath will contaminate samples.
The hair is then dissolved and prepped for sequencing.
That's where we've made a lot of kind of strides in forensics. We've developed techniques to really process the small quantities and small fragment lengths of these really degraded samples.
Like the degraded samples from a decades-old case in New Hampshire, the Bearbrook murders, where four females were killed in the late 70s and discovered in barrels in 1985 and 2000. Law enforcement contacted the UC Santa Cruz team to help them identify the women using hair samples retrieved from those barrels.
It's definitely moved beyond just being interested in processing weird, bad samples. When we got into forensics, that real world application I hadn't experienced before, and that's kind of the direction that I want to move. I really like that we're helping solving crimes, and I like that we're able to bring justice for these crimes.
Now, the team hopes to get other agencies to use this work. They say current forensic data that's been used for decades doesn't match with the data they're using. So right now, they're informing other agencies on how this new work can be integrated into what they're doing.
I was going to say, but it's becoming more and more accepted.
Exactly. Exactly.
Fascinating.
Very fascinating.
Fascinating.
Thank you.
Thanks, Alana.
The team is not at liberty to identify which agencies and investigations specifically they are involved with, except, of course, for that New Hampshire case.